Good afternoon, everyone. I am Jacob. I am the teacher at Sopakama Primary School teaching English. Now, we have got a wonderful story of a girl. I mean, let me tell you that every year at Sopakama Primary School, our learners go out to, for what we call farewell parties. I mean, just to celebrate the end of their seven-year program there. Now, 2014, when I was just looking at my learners because I was their grade 7 teacher, realized that one of the learners were not as jovial as the rest of them were. Then 2 days before their celebrations, I was expecting everyone to be as happy as, maybe I don't know. But now this learner came to me straight. Look, learners at times, they trust you to the extent that they take you so close. You are almost their father or mother. Now, this learner came straight to me, told me that her mother told her that because of financial constraints, she could not go to grade 8. And I said, don't say that, because she was she was the best learner in our school. So it really touched me. So I just said to her, like I did not promise her too much. I just said to her, okay, fine. I heard your story. I'll see what I can do. Then from there, I went straight to RNA. He's sitting there. Can you raise up your hand, please? I want everyone to see you. Right. I went straight to him. I told him my story. We both cried. It was literal cry. We shed tears. Why did we shed tears? Because we could not imagine the best learner in the school failing to go to the next level. He literally cried. I cried. And from there, he said, so what is the way forward? Because crying was not enough. The learner still was supposed to go to school. So 2 days later, 3 days later, he wrote me an email. He said, where do you think the learner should go and learn? And I said, I'm not sure, because she is not looking for any place, because her mother told her she could not go to the next level. So there is no way she would try anything or getting some place at the high school. He said, run around. I took my car, ran around all the schools around in, we stay in Tableview there. Now, I ran around, went to a school called Blaubeck High. I told him, I went to Blaubeck, and I told them our story, and they said they can at least interview the child, but then there is no total guarantee that the child will get a place. And he said, convince them. So I went back again and I told them, guys, we don't have any other space and we don't have anything else that we can do. And I mean, only what I've got to do is to take the child. But of course, she has to go through your processes. And they took her through their processes. She passed the interview. Then he told me that he and his possibilities, or partners for possibilities, were going to pay for that child. And I could not believe. And I said, what payment are you talking about? Are you talking about buying some uniforms? Then that's the end of it. He said, he's talking about 100% payment, including her transport from where she's staying to her school. Let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, whoever started this Partners for Possibilities deserve much better than what we're seeing today. This is a massive thing. I've got this girl there. Please stand up. Come to the front. Now, this is Simbulele Mgengo. I taught her 2014 grade 7. And she remains the jewel for our school. At Blaubeck there, she's making wonders. She's one of their finest. And I introduce to you this girl. She has only a few words for you. Please enjoy.
Hi, my name is Simulele Mgengo and I'm in grade 10 at Blaubeck Drone High School. I am here today to share my story because I would like people to know that the starfish story is true. In 2014, Mr. Jacob Funyura, my English teacher, took me under his wing because he wanted me to prosper in life so I could go to a better high school. Even though I was a top achiever in my primary, my family couldn't afford the fees of a good high school. This is when Mr. Funyura took the chance and talked to Mr. Aaron Robin Hamer and Mr. Robin Hamer, when he heard my story, he contacted one of his rugs distributors, Benelux, who decided to offer financial support, and I received the very first Rocks Academy scholarship. This enabled me to attend Blobbekran High School. This partnership has had a massive impact on my life. I am working hard and trying my best because I have hope for my future. Last year, I achieved first position for English home language, whereby Xhosa is my home language. And I was also awarded fourth position for the grade nines, for the whole grade nines, and I was also elected RCL leader for the grade teens. I am proud of this opportunity, as now I can improve my people skills and learn to become a leader. I wish to have an impact on someone's life, like Rocks had an impact on my life, and I would like to thank Partners for Possibilities for making this, for giving me a chance to speak in front of other people here, and I would like to thank Mr. Jacob Funyura, Rocks, Benelux, and especially Yolande for being my mentor. Thank you.
I am so humbled to hear her saying that, having done the little that I did, and it looks like the whole world is only in your hands. And I wish you would continue doing whatever you're doing. You're making an impact. Thank you.